If you take a closer look at earwax, you will find that it's not just made of fat. It was used as balm and applied to wounds to protect them from infection, and they weren't far from the truth. But what exactly is earwax? Earwax is produced in the outer ear canal. The glands there produce sweat and oils, which mix with dead and keratinized skin cells. The keratin from these cells is what can harden the earwax. So earwax is a mixture, but like a fingerprint, its texture, color, and smell are completely unique. European, American, and African population tend to have wet earwax, which is about 50% fat, while Asian population have dry earwax. Healthy earwax is typically light brown or yellowish. White earwax often indicates that less earwax is being produced. If you notice dark brown or black earwax, it's because the wax is older and has oxidized. Gray earwax usually suggests that dirt has entered your ear. If your earwax turns green or develops an unusual or unpleasant odor, this could be a sign of infection and you should consult a doctor. And if you live in a polluted city, you are likely to produce more earwax. Why? Because earwax's job is to protect your ears from infections. Research has shown that earwax is just as effective as an antibiotic when it comes to killing bacteria. And you still plan to remove the earwax from your ears? The fact is, even in medieval Europe, they were already doing this. There were a small hooked metal tool called curette used for this. Will you have put that in your ear? Oh, you want to clean it with a cotton swab? Today's modern cotton swab was invented by
Leo Gersten Zhang.
In 1923, he created the first cotton swab after seeing his wife use a toothpick wrapped in cotton to clean their child's ear. This idea inspired him, and Gersten Zhang later created a brand, Baby Gaze, which was the predecessor to today's Q-tips. However, according to doctors, using the cotton swab only pushes the earwax deeper, and by irritating the skin of your ear canal can cause inflammation. Before you reach for your ear candle, which actually does more harm than good since there is no scientific evidence that it removes earwax, you should know that under normal circumstances, earwax comes out on its own. When you chew, the movement helps the earwax travel outward. So if you can, let your ears clean themselves, and only clean them on the outside. Yes, I know what you're thinking. There are times when earwax can form a plug, such as ear pain, feeling a pressure, headaches, or if your ear clogs up when you blow your nose. According to WHO, if you have these symptoms, don't try to clean your ears at home. Instead, see a doctor who will professionally flush them out. See you next time.